Welcome to a November 23rd Selectmen's meeting here in the town of Deerfield, which we were not supposed to have before Thanksgiving, but we are. So this is limited time.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Get you out quick.
I appreciate that John and John have both come.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, and we appreciate, if you have input, please feel free. This is going to be a discussion on since we don't really have anybody's way to discuss, we're going to talk about how we felt about the interviews. And, I'll just go first.
Okay.
Can I just say something about one of the candidates?
Sure.
Casey Warren did withdraw her candidacy.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I have a letter to that effect.
Oh, so we're down to two. Okay. Well, I was going to say one of the things with Casey is she could just walk right into the job because she has a lot of experience.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll just skip over that whole big thing. Then we'll go on to the second candidate. Ira, I mean, I really did like Ira.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of our committees, a lot of our departments have, you know, had a lot of turmoil, and I think his calming influence is really good. The biggest deal is we're constantly watching the budget year-round. He's been on the finance committee, and he's been on the school committee, and mm-hmm. I feel like he could work really well with you and Lynn Carey. I mean, after all, about almost 70% of our budget is school-related.
Yeah.
This is not anti-school. It's because they are getting pinched. They have
sure.
to do more with
they
less
do.
As well. But I feel like he could work with you and Lynn,
mm-hmm.
and you could think out of the box a little bit. He'd be calming. We could work downtown with economic development. I mean, it was very sad when Jerry's was closed. It had a huge, to me, it was a real negative impact to our downtown not to have the activity of Jerry's Place.
And yeah.
So we really need to make the downtown more walkable, sociable, and bring in more businesses. And mm-hmm. problem is, huge learning curve.
Yes.
If he's willing to work with our resources, and he has a seemingly huge amount of resources himself to call on, and he's willing to eliminate some of his volunteer stuff, like being a selectman.
Right.
I mean, being a selectman is a full-time job, so
right.
he needs
right.
to look to here, so that would be an issue.
Right.
And would he be willing to do this job for 6 months, in my mind, to see? I mean, we've already had somebody with no experience.
Right.
So I feel like we need to have a trial period. And
mm-hmm.
if he's willing to do that, then I'm okay.
Yeah.
Natasha has lots of energy. She's bright, young, but
yes.
I have to say I was really turned off the fact that, you know, she wanted the top dollar
mm-hmm.
and she wasn't going to come. And it would be a huge training curve and learning curve. And, you know, we have so much stuff going on. We have the EMS. We have senior center and senior housing this is all happening really fast, and it's going to take a lot of people talking with her and doing stuff, and I don't know if she has the patience to deal with all the people, and that would be my thing is,
okay.
So for what it's worth, I'm saying I would really like Ira, I think, as a risk, try take a chance.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
I agree with pretty much everything that you said. I don't know, has anybody asked Ira if he would be willing to give up his volunteer work in South Hadley?
No, we haven't. We haven't.
Yeah,
talked.
We'd have to go into negotiations, I guess.
No, that hasn't been discussed. And as you pointed out, that is something in the position description. And it's your discretion. And it would probably be a good idea to
yeah.
exercise that discretion.
Right. I think so.
There's issues around management ethics in the ICMA, the International City County Management Association, and the Mass Municipal Management Association, which is the organization for town administrators and town managers, that ethically requires someone who is a manager or administrator to not hold elective office.
Right.
My thing would just be, it would be time factor.
And he, you know, he was very thorough in all his stuff, so I'm sure he read that and wouldn't apply it if he wasn't thinking of something
right.
down.
And you could possibly do it when there's a next election so as not to cost another community a special election or something
right.
like that.
Right.
But that's going down the road already, so.
Correct.
There are a lot of things to this that, you know, we didn't really get to get answers for, at least I felt I didn't because of the way we did this, which is okay.
Yeah.
I have to say that I did like Natasha's energy.
Mm-hmm.
I did like the fact that she had, you know, 6 years of education directly in this field. Her experience was extremely limited. I would not have offered her the job at the top rate anyways.
Right.
I would have felt more comfortable at a lower rate and to see how quickly she could grasp the operations of the community. But one of my concerns with her is that I do think that she's talented and energetic, and I'm concerned that it might be more of a short-term deal with her. You know, she might come here, and even if things worked out well, I feel that she'd be constantly searching for a better job, closer to her roots, for more money. And I think that as important it is for the community to have responsible management, stable management is also a priority.
I do too.
So for that reason, I would be, you know, willing to give Ira the opportunity to see if he can, you know, get on board, and, you know, also not offer him the top amount, and maybe even offer him a lesser amount, and with a promise that if he can meet the expectations of the management, to give him not a bonus, but to make an immediate transition from whatever we offer to a higher rate, not to the top, but
right.
And we could base that number on his ability to grasp everything.
Right.
You know, and I know that it's been a huge learning curve for me to understand everything that goes on in the community, and I've spent countless hours reading, and I'm a long way from being able to do that job as well. So
It takes time.
I think the stability of all your comments, the stability is really, I mean, that
it is.
We are missing so much, you guys. I mean, really.
I know we are.
I know it doesn't seem like.
Right.
We've been trying to do as much as we can and stay on top of stuff, but we truly are letting stuff fall through.
When I sat through the initial process and then here, I had scored Natasha very high because I thought I really loved her, her passion and her the amount of energy she had to put into the job, and I felt like it would be really nice to have that kind of direction in town. But I do worry that it is. Would be a stepping stone for her, and I, what I want immensely for this job is consistency and somebody to be here for a while. And I could overlook not having the full experience in the job. How I do think he's experienced and he knows what goes on, but he has a lot. Ira would have a lot to learn, and I think Natasha would. Anybody that jumps into this town has got a lot to learn, just the way we run things and how it all works. But I did really like her passion and her views and where she would take the town, but I am concerned that it is far away from her area. And I really feel consensus on this board is really important. And what I love about Ira is his calming presence. And I think that he could deal with people coming into town with a problem, could listen to them empathetically, and people would go away feeling like he really heard me. And whether he could or couldn't help them, that they at least had a voice here in town, and I think that he could work with the department heads really well. And you know, he's going to listen and get up to speed if we offer him the job. But I felt consistency, you know, between the two people we have left now. I think I would offer it to Ira too, just close to the area, the ability to learn, his calming presence, and I think, you know, initially if side by side, I think Natasha could do the job better first, but I think there would be a leapfrog action in about a year or two. And if he would give us, you know, several years here, I think he could really go a long ways. I loved his business. You know, I love the ability to want to bring business to this town. And
I do too.
And you know, rejuvenate downtown. That's just kind of where I'm thinking. But
and I agree with that, but I've heard that comment here before, and that, you know, I'd like to, I guess, caution the board that a good town administrator could facilitate that. But we do have bylaws and policies in this community that I feel are not exactly business friendly.
Detrimental,
right? our policies, in my opinion, tend to lend themselves toward, I don't know how to word it, the feel-good of the community, and it's the benefit of the whole community. Well, not that that's not important, but sometimes a business application can't fit within those parameters,
mm-hmm.
and that you have to expose yourself a little bit, you know, and I'm not saying let a nuclear plant in, but, you know, you have to, you know, give things a chance to see how they go. And, you know, when people are looking to invest their hard-earned money, sometimes their life savings in a business, you know, you need a community that will be somewhat business-friendly, you know.
I would love to work with you on, you know, making the environment more business-friendly. If we could look at our town bylaws or whatever we need to do to kind of get that to happen. If we're setting up roadblocks to business, I'd love to know what those are and figure out a way to
well,
lessen
we
that.
Don't, I know that's not what this meeting's about, but
right.
I can give you an earful.
Well, I'm sure you can.
That's why you're on the planning board. You need to sort it out. But anyway, so there seems to be consensus for IRA. Is that true?
Yes,
I think
okay,
so.
Okay, let's, but there are some concerns. So let's make a list. One of them was, you know, like a probationary period,
mm-hmm.
maybe 6 months. I mean, does that seem reasonable?
Yes,
to you
and
guys?
There is something in our bylaws that kind of, you know, justifies that as well, a probationary type period. And I think that I would not think that he would be really opposed to that because he self-admittedly said he doesn't know how the mechanics
right.
of this work. You know, he's willing to learn, but he doesn't know. And
right.
being a businessman, he would understand that if you hire an accountant that can't really do everything, you know, you're willing to give him a chance, but after 6 months, you're getting letters from the IRS and, you know, you're not paying your taxes, that, you know, you got to make a change. So.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
No, I think part of it is we want to make sure he reaches out to his resources and
mm-hmm.
our resources and
great.
Make sure that this happens. John.
Make a final decision. I guess I want to express a concern that I have that we're ending up with a compromise. I think we did the same thing with the screening committee. I don't have my papers in front of me because Wendy confiscated them all. But I honestly don't think I had Ira that highly rated. I think I might have had him fourth or fifth. But we agreed, I think, amongst the screening committee to put him ahead of some of the other candidates because of salary, for one thing. I mean, I had one person who I thought was pretty good and actually withdrew.
Yeah.
But I thought would have been a better candidate. My concern with Ira is that he's a businessman. He has been his own boss. He doesn't answer to a board. He's not a corporate officer who, you know, has to answer to a board of directors. Nothing wrong with being a businessman. I've been one myself for 40-something years. But you're your own boss. So you do things your own way. He hasn't had an administrative position in terms of municipal government. There's a little caution.
There is.
John, what would can you think of a safeguard? Because that's why I was thinking of this probationary period. I mean, we obviously have the discussion up front about that. But can you think of another safeguard that we could institute that would address that?
I mean,
we've had that problem.
Yeah.
And that's, I mean, over the years, as you know, this is not a new thing. So.
As much as he thinks his wife's going to take over and run his business, you know, I caution that too because.
Well, I mean, that's why I think, again, this is going to be one of the conditions, is that, you know, he focused on Deerfield. But I think, honestly, he would want to focus on Deerfield because he would want to keep his job. So, you know, how he phases himself out, I would think, would be part of the probationary evaluation, would be that we would be seeing, is he available to us? I mean, we're, the three of us are in here all the time.
I know.
So, and we're here at different times. I mean, it's not a set time. It's random for all three of us. So I think that in itself is a check, because, I mean, I'm here when I have meetings, I stop in. You know, if I'm going to Northampton or Amherst, I'm stopping in here on the way. And Kip is around all the time, and Trevor, I mean, you're in and out different times of the day, too. So I think we'll be able to keep track of that kind of thing.
But I agree with him. I do feel that this is a compromise.
Yeah.
You know, the process, you know, like, I personally don't really like it. I think that if it was different, we could have asked him all of these questions right up front. Are you willing to do this? Are you willing to do that? And then had an answer. And then if that wasn't satisfactory, we could dismiss him and go on to somebody else.
It's hard.
But, you know, I don't get to make all the rules. So, I just, one of the things that I do like, or I think that I like about Ira, if, once again, I think Natasha would, I think that she would do a better job. I don't know how long she would stay, or if she didn't do a good job, what hassles we would have with her along the way, where I just think Ira's personality, it would be easier to deal with, to make adjustments like, you know, yeah, this is kind of your job, but don't really do it like this or something like that. I've always said when I took this job, I didn't want to micromanage any department, but it's hard to, if you see something wrong, how do you necessarily get that point across without trying to micromanage? You know, you can make suggestions and stuff like that. I just think that Ira's personality might bend a little better than Natasha's. And I could be wrong. You know, even though she's a strong girl, she, in her ability or her desire to learn, she might be extremely flexible. Mm. But that's one of the invariables. You know, you just don't know. And I hate to, in this sense, penalize her for that, because I don't know, but, you know, I don't. So I don't know.
Yeah, I had her highly rated. I thought she was impressive. She actually was a little more impressive with your interview, I think, than...
That's what Trevor said. Trevor
came
said,
across with
yeah.
the screening committee. Mm-hmm. You know, as far as the salary goes, I wouldn't fault anybody for wanting the highest and the best. I mean, that's, you know, whether she'd take a starting position or not, I don't know. You'd have to talk with her about that. But and the fact that, yeah, she may be only here for a few years, but so what? I mean, if you're getting a good quality person in that position, the fact that this is a beginning for them, I mean,
you can't
ultimately think that, you know, the mayor of Boston or the mayor of New York is going to come here and take over.
Yeah.
I mean, this is Deerfield.
I know, but we need stability. We have so much stuff going on, John, and we have let so much stuff slip. And I feel like I just don't want to be I don't want to have to invest in training her and then also be the resume building community.
But with that being said, I mean, if we considered offering her the job under the same premises we would to Ira, look at this is going to be a temporary thing. You know, maybe she right up front would say, look, I'm not looking for this for 6 months, and say, you know, I don't want anything to do with this. But you know, it's 6 months. I mean, I think that we could get a good sense of where this is going if we did offer her the job, like Ira, you know, and then in 6 months it wasn't working out, we can still part ways.
I just want to move on.
She was, just to be clear, I think it is clear, but she was adamant she would not accept the position for the highest amount. Just to let you know that, I'm not saying that puts her out of the running. That's your decision, but that was made very clear.
And I have to tell you, that was kind of a turnoff, really. I mean, she's applying to us for us to give us a job, give her a job. She's unemployed. She was not renewed, and she's been unemployed for several months. And I want the top, and that's not even enough. And
but that comes from it can come from a lot of different areas. Just so you understand, one is that a big factor is where she lives. I mean, where she lives now, they probably pay $5 for a bottle of water, and their property taxes are almost double what we pay. So when people are used to different things, you know, and her education and. You know, oh, if you get this, you'd. I mean, I'm just saying that all those things factor in. But I'm still not advocating to do that. But if we'd consider offer her maybe $70,000, and if she says no, I won't do that, say fine, thank you. But you know, I don't know. I do all along through this whole process. I do think she would do a better job. My one concern is how long would she stay, and you know, what kind of a fit would she be.
Yeah, I don't think you should rule anyone out just because they asked for a higher amount to start with.
No.
I mean, I think that would be a criteria that wasn't appropriate to determine who is going to get the job. I really don't.
Yeah.
Well, it was the attitude, I guess. I mean, she should have waited till, I mean, in my mind, that's part of the negotiation. You wait until you actually get the job offer.
But she hasn't mentioned that anywhere other than in her application.
But a good and
oh, she did verbally as well.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. But well. I agree with you, and agree with you.
But that also can
and
be
it's not atypical for applicants to say that in their just to.
But that kind of holds true with what she did say about her personality being a strong personality and stuff like that. You know, and that can be a good thing and maybe a bad thing, but you know, and it's so real, it's so difficult to to do this. You know?
Well, here's a question: before you finally decide, you could do a 1-2 thing, unless one or two is not accepted. You know, if candidate A doesn't accept the position or you don't work things out, are you willing to go forward with candidate two or not?
I feel like we have consensus, though, of some sort. And it is a compromise, John. But
well, that's what I'm afraid of. And
I know.
I'm not sure that's, as a town, that's where we should be going. I understand, but
I personally feel really good with that choice of Ira. I just really do. I think, granted, he's not the mayor of Boston, but I think he could get up to speed pretty quick on what we have, and I love his personality, and I just felt really comfortable working with him. But that's just my two cents. I mean, I love Natasha too. I thought she'd do a very good job. I just worry about a stepping stone kind of thing. I'm really looking for consistency in the town for a while. It's been leapfrog for years here. I haven't been involved with town that long, but it's just been a constant. Kind of interim.
Well, it's very wearing, and we just aren't getting stuff done, and
I don't know. I hate to jump in, but I keep hearing the word compromise, and the word compromise means to me the search didn't produce a outstanding candidate. Okay.
I agree.
I personally think the board should only hire an interim administrator for 6 months, and that interim should understand that it's interim, and if they cut the mustard in that 6 month time period, that you would consider them the primary candidate for the town administrator's job. I think it is absolutely wrong to hire somebody as a compromise just because of the budget season coming. And what I did notice about every single candidate, not one of the candidates stepped forward and said, what would you do in the first 2 weeks? The first 2 weeks, I would meet with the highway department, I would meet with the police department, I would meet with some of the people in town, I would meet with some of the committees, zoning board, et cetera, capital planning, capital improvement, before I came up with a plan of action. I did not see any candidates.
Yeah, I think both of them kind of did that, I think.
That was a question that you asked.
I didn't see anybody step forward and say that in the interviews that we had.
Yeah.
Okay? So what I'm saying is, I don't like the statement compromise. It sounds like you're in desperation.
Do we use the word compromise or consensus?
I don't feel it's a compromise at all. I feel comfortable with the choice, but I also, you're choosing between three people. I don't think it's a compromise. It's just a consolidation of what you think the best one out of all three is.
I understand that, Trevor, but what I'm trying to say is, you have a minimal experience person,
mm-hmm.
you have a no experience person.
Mm-hmm.
Personalities are different.
Sure.
Okay? I'll use Ira for an example. Ira appears to have a very good personality, appears like he can do the job very well, but he has no experience.
Mm-hmm.
So if the board was to choose Ira, for example, and Wendy, I hate to say this, but I think somebody like a Wendy needs to be mentoring that person for the time period, or the selectmen need to have somebody as a go-to.
I think that's understood.
I don't think you can throw any one of the candidates in the fire without backup.
Oh, yeah.
I think that was kind of understood, Dick.
I'm still very adamant about the fact that there should be the 6 months probationary period that's required by our town bylaws.
I think we're...
Yeah, I think that was part of what we're talking about. Well, how are you seeing that an interim 6 months is different than a probationary 6 months?
Well...
Can I just say that you advertise for town administrator, not an interim town administrator, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then my suggestion to this board would be to whoever the candidate you pick is you call that person back in and have the same discussion you're having right now about the probationary period and what you're going to need for help or assistance.
Sure.
And ask those, specifically ask those questions.
Yeah.
It's a day before Thanksgiving. I do not think it's critical that you make a decision right this minute. I think it needs some thought after some of the input from John, not particularly myself, but my suggestion would be to call your number one choice between the three members of the board back and have this discussion that, okay, here's what we're faced with. What do you think?
Yeah, that's,
and then make a decision.
That was our
plan,
right?
Do you have time to do this, Wendy, before
I could try this today, but I'm also one of you could do this and express the sentiments of the board and have that conversation. And then,
I think that was the plan, right?
If you had come to a consensus around IRA, as it sounded like you were going, and then upon successful negotiations, offer the position upon, and those all criteria, Dick has covered some of what you've already talked about. You decide what those criteria would be,
that would be part
of your negotiation offer.
I want to make sure that we get everything in the list.
Yeah.
I mean, I think number one was the 6 months probationary period, because there's a learning curve for absolutely both,
mm-hmm.
but we need, and Ira has to transition out of his other commitments.
Could we have another member of our
screening committee? Bring him on the spot.
John, you have been awfully...
But he's kind of quiet.
Actually, John, you have an excellent point, because John has been extremely quiet. So what
are you saying? I'm normally not.
Yes. You definitely have an opinion.
We usually don't know where you're coming from, John.
Exactly.
We're not sure what your point of view is.
Not hearing from you makes me a little nervous, too. So why don't you say what you have to say?
I think that all the candidates are incredible. Like any of us sitting here in this room, they all have their strengths and weaknesses. So what we have to focus on is the needs of Deerfield. And we know that stability is one of them. We know personality traits is one of them, because we're a very well-educated town. People are very involved in government. There's many boards. There's many department heads. full-time, part-time, so you need the personality to have that total mix. And when I look back on the candidates, you know, we interviewed 6 out of the initial 10 applicants, and we forwarded 4 to the Board of Selectmen. As I'm told today, one's withdrawn, and so, and one withdrew 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
So we're down to ultimately 2. So when we examine Natasha and Ira, I think both are great. But what we're doing is we have to compare personalities. Who is the board, the department heads, and the townspeople going to work best with? That's a key question. Mm. To me, I think it's going to be Ira. I think that Natasha's an incredible choice, but I think his more laid-back and well-thought-out approach is going to bring people together. Mm-hmm. When you are quick to make decisions, when you're quick and confident, sometimes it pushes people away. And it actually, that positive becomes a negative. So, I mean, it's a difficult choice for the board. I enjoy both candidates. Personality-wise, I would absolutely side with Ira. So then we have to look at experience. Natasha's got incredible degrees. He has more life experience. She has a town administrator position for 1 year, but then again, it was in Connecticut, not Massachusetts. I mean, that's oil and water. He was on the finance committee, the school committee, a board of selectmen in Massachusetts. So to me, they're on an even playing field there when you combine all those factors together. So to me, it comes down to the personality. Who can you best work with? Who's going to be your workhorse, your conduit between boards? Because the last thing the Board of Selectmen wants is somebody that comes in and creates animosity, controversy, pushes people away, because it puts you in a damage control mode. All the progressive motion you have actually comes to a halt. So to me, I think Ira's the logical choice when I look at all those facts.
I have to say that's how mm-hmm. I viewed it too, but I just feel we have to have this calming factor and he's, you know, he doesn't have to prove anything other than the fact that he's competent. And I mean, he's not moving on.
I think she's amazing, but I think she may be too amazing. That's
for our position.
I know that's it. That's an oxymoron.
John, I know.
I get it, but I'm telling you, if you want my feeling, that's my feeling. Okay. Yes.
It's too bad that there's this need to have to make a decision so quickly, because frankly, I would recommend that you start all over again. I mean, that would be my instinct. You know, I have to be honest. I think all the candidates were good. But I don't think I gave anybody a 5 in our ratings. I know some of the other members of our committee did. But,
yeah, you were pretty frugal. Yeah.
But I be honest with you, I didn't think one of them was that outstanding over the other ones.
The problem where we're at right now, John, is, and I think we discussed this in closed doors, is we haven't revamped the salary in 8 years. So we want a dynamic, incredible, experienced individual to come here, but we didn't post the position at a salary level to attract that individual.
Right.
So we basically set ourselves up for failure from 1. Doesn't mean we don't have great candidates. I like both of them. So I told you who my choice would be.
So John, you're really against...
Oh, no, no, I'm not saying I'm against...
Oh.
No.
So... What if we had the 6 months? What if we just gave it 6 months? I mean, I feel like, I mean, it is a risk, but if we do the 6 months, we get through the budget year and town meeting. And if he does, his personality will come out in that 6 months. How can you not show your true colors by going through that? I mean, because we're so far behind. I mean, Brenda's doing the budget sheets and, you know, she's acting like our finance director really already. So, and we might actually end up reorganizing, since he has less experience, we might end up I mean, this is, I haven't even talked to Trevor or Kip about this, but it seems like maybe Brenda is really enjoying, you know, the conversations I had. I mean, maybe it makes sense that we have a finance director. Everybody goes to her anyway, so, and then that would take some pressure off the town administrator's job. So, I mean, I could see this morphing towards something like that anyway. So I don't know.
Well, as I'm sitting here thinking, part of what I saw Doug struggle with is that he was doing so much stuff, and every time I went in there, I mean, he'd be talking to me, and his fingers are going a mile a minute. I was surprised that anything came out on the thing except for But with Ira and his personality, I think one of the things that talk about setting someone up for failure, we start throwing all this stuff at him with his laid-back personality. How is he going to deal with learning the job and then doing the job? You know, that might be a difficult thing. So then I think, well, you know, he really needs a good person in there that can do a lot of the typing, you know, making sure this gets posted and doing that, just overseeing it. So now you get into, now you're paying two people, so now you get back into the salary thing. Now you're paying two people versus paying one, and, you know, so.
Well, we've always had an executive assistant. That's been empty.
And we got to fill
But that. Also, you can't confuse activity with actual production.
Exactly.
And that's what we have found out, that sitting and typing
right,
doesn't necessarily.
Right, but if you have to sit and respond to a DEP thing, then you have to respond to that office over there, then you have to respond to South County EMS. That person that's typing that's doing that response is not doing the administrative job. They are. Those are administrative things, but it's not part of the town administrator thing. They're clerical things that somebody else could do, you know.
But I would assume that when you come back from vacation that we would start the process for executive assistant.
I think you wanted to wait until you have, that's a town administrator, right?
Oh, yes.
Right?
We have the town administrator on the board, but then we would also.
Well, they can take care
of
that. Yeah.
Then I feel that we could hire someone that is very strong with experience by changing.
Yeah, everything fell on when you went without an executive assistant, everything fell on Doug's shoulders, including a lot that he didn't know about. I mean, he knew what he learned as an executive assistant, but he had to both do that, learn more about that job, and then learn everything
It was incredible because he would be here at a planning board meeting, and he's taking care of the plans, the documents, dealing with, you know, the contract with the FERCOG, and he's also asking me about select board stuff, and, you know, that's a lot for any one person.
Right. Well, that isn't really, I don't know when that became part of the being engaged with the planning board.
Oh, yeah.
A town administrator responsibility.
Right, but he
past.
Was here taking our minutes and doing that, getting involved with all that, making the plans. Okay. And, you know.
The job somewhat, you know, has to, how it's done is partly by the person who's in it, as you could tell by the three people, how they would approach things, you know.
Right.
And I think, as you've seen with the different people who have been here, at least you, we've all brought our thing, you know, this is our area of expertise, or this is our interest area, or, you know, I've got to learn about this, or I'm really good at this, so, you know, the town needs it all. The town needs it all, so.
Well, I know who I would hire, but she won't take the job.
I know, we've already been talking.
Okay. Well, she might.
Let me remind you, we're on
television. I think FEMA's going out of business.
I'm perfectly fine making that statement on television.
And I can say that the screening committee was unanimous in that same vein.
I think several boards of selectmen have been unanimous as well. But anyway, listen, I got to get my turkey. So what are we going to do? What do you guys want to do?
I make a motion to offer the job to Ira Brzezinski with providing
successful contract negotiations
with a 6-month probation period.
I'll second the motion.
Okay. Let's clarify before I ask for a vote. Let's clarify the conditions. We have a 6-month probationary period and that we would ask him.
the
We had phased out.
Separation of his selectman duties.
Phasing out of his volunteer commitments, because it seemed like he.
Commitment to Deerfield.
So he.
We want to get clear on that.
Go ahead.
Exactly.
I agree.
So phasing out?
Phasing out.
Yeah.
And as we say this, that's a big thing on his part.
Yes.
Because he's taking a risk on a six-month job where he's going to give up an elected position that he's wanted and give up positions on board that he's in a community where he lives for over 20 years. That's huge, so.
Can you require that? Can you require him to give up?
It's two things. One is it is in the position description that the position, the person in that position not hold another elective office except with the permission of the board. So it's specifically called out, and I'm sure that comes from.
But is that within this community or anywhere?
It's both.
I'd have to read that over again.
It's both. Yeah, I hadn't picked up on it because it wasn't something I was, you know. We tend to not see people holding other offices, but Kip had pointed that out, and then I researched that more. It is an ethical standard for municipal managers to not be involved in electoral positions, okay.
Positions. And my position on that, John, is, you know, it's a huge commitment to be a select board person, and I don't.
Oh, sure it is.
Okay. And I don't want to compete with South Hadley on this.
Well, you don't remember?
Oh, I remember.
My only problem, I don't have a problem that he was a select board member or he had any of those things. Well, the problem came from me is when, you know, we needed him here, now all of a sudden it was a conflict for him. You know, he's got an obligation there and an obligation here. And I didn't want this community to suffer.
Right.
So
I mean,
that was my only concern.
You're torn. I mean, you want to do 100%.
Wouldn't be opposed to a school committee or something, but I don't even think he's on that anymore. But
no, he's a selectman, I think, now. But just phasing out of whatever.
Okay, I believe he's been on it for 4 years, which might mean this is the end of his third-year cycle, so I don't know.
No.
But
Can you think of some other things that you were interested in?
Well, obviously we discussed about training and that kind of stuff.
Salary?
You guys can always put in more stuff in executive session when you actually do the contract negotiation, so you don't have to formulate everything
right
now.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I could begin the conversation with him, and then for the further discussion, you can come back and meet. I think you should.
Yeah.
Have a negotiated.
Well,
session.
I think it would make us feel
one of
more comfortable that we could talk about, you know, issues that that John has raised. I mean, and I certainly feel experienced in those kind of issues. So I would be nice to have some reassurance.
And if this
he understands. I mean, and the perfect example is we seem to have, I mean, Casey really didn't have a problem with it, but we seem to have a real issue on Dick's building commissioner stuff and his Board of Health stuff. He needs to be in the loop. We call our lawyer to get a position. Dick needs to ask the question. He needs to hear the answer, so he can interpret it based on his knowledge of the codes. And the town administrator is there so they're in the loop and to understand what's going on, but they're not there to ask the question, make a decision on the zoning, and then send letters out.
Yes. To the police department.
Correct.
Absolutely. But I'm just saying, John tells them, but if for whatever reason, Dick, this has been several administrators have had issues with you not being in the loop when we talk to our town lawyer. John clears everything through his police lawyer first because that's free, and if there's more issues, then we go to the municipal point. But John does do that himself already. But you have to go to our municipal lawyer, and to be out of the loop just drives me wacko because it's a poor decision for us.
You know, if I do some transition work, which I anticipate, at least in a memo, I will emphasize that as something that we could get very clear about whose jobs how you work with them.
Yeah, how you work with the department
heads. Keep communication is everything.
Right.
I think that is one of the strong points of Ira that I liked is if I come to him and say, look, it's very important that you make sure that this man is notified here, and he'd go, oh, yeah, sure, where I don't know about the other candidate. If it was like, well, you know, I'm supposed to know what I'm doing, or, you know, I don't know that.
Mm-hmm.
you know, and I, if I worked with her, I would, could probably, after a week, say, you know, I was totally wrong. I shouldn't have thought that. But, you know, not knowing, it's just...
I feel like you'd be really good with communication.
You know, I think Wendy's going to get mad at me, but I haven't heard her hear the board ask her if she could be a resource for a few months.
That is what I meant by saying our resource.
She's going to kill me
after this meeting. No. Dick, that was part of the... whoever we chose, understand that that was our resource.
Well, the board needs to have that conversation.
And that mentor. But I feel very
comfortable with a resource, the go-to person.
Yeah. I mean, I would feel that, you know, that would be a condition of...
Well, here's a nice segue. When I did references, I did find out that from that Ira has been taking advantage of every single, and you,
yes,
in fact, met him at a meeting, even as a select board member, and not anticipating coming here necessarily, but over time has been taking every training, every workshop, everything that's available. So I think, you know, that was a plus about.
Mm-hmm. And I think he's at a point in his life he doesn't have to prove who's in charge, and so he would be willing to work with you. I mean, I think mentoring would be successful
if you're willing.
If you're willing, yes. I mean, we're hoping. Able.
I would second Richard's motion. That I don't view it as a possibility. I view it as a necessity.
Well,
that would be part of the negotiation.
This is a board decision.
Well, that would be part of the negotiation, John. I think is when, I mean, Wendy has to say yes, but he also has to agree that
my number one candidate for the job.
May I just suggest that you ask that he may be very amenable to support services as a board.
Yes.
Would suggest, you know, keep it open in general.
Okay.
Could be training, could be whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would think so. So, okay. So, if there's no further discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. So, it's unanimous. Wendy, are you going to call Ira, and would you call Natasha as well?
Yes.
And then, would you try to, we are meeting next Tuesday.
Meeting, is that the 29th?
Yes, the 29th. So maybe we could go into executive session with Ira at that point.
Okay. I believe also Bill Solomon's coming finally with the cable
contract.
Really?
Carolyn, if you need to, what you can do is designate a representative from the Board of Selectmen to sit down with Wendy and Ira at any point in time.
Well, it's just that Wendy's not going to be out of town.
Day, I'm going to Florida next week, see my mom for 2 weeks. So.
Yeah, so.
But I think that's a good idea that one of you should be the negotiator, you know, if you need to talk to him outside of your next meeting where you have him in to finalize things, if that's what you end up doing.
Well, I mean, obviously, I'm chair, but I feel like he should come in Tuesday and talk to all three of us in executive session. I want to keep us... all three of us together. I think it's important that we have consensus and that we're moving together. And I don't think given his personality, I mean, this is what attracted me to him, is I don't think he's going to have a problem working with the three of us together, right?
Right.
We'll start off on that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think it's important that we're together as a board. He needs to work with us as a board, so we can negotiate together as a board. I feel it's more important that we stick together. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Is that okay with you?
I'm all right with it because I don't necessarily see a downside to it.
Okay. I mean, I just feel it's important we stick together.
Is there a downside to it?
Is there a downside because
you do this in executive session.
Right.
You just... be on, you know, on the same board. You need to show that you're united in where you're going when you have the conversation with him.
But I think that, but Wendy, that's...
on the specifics. I don't mean him, but on the specifics.
I mean, I think there is consensus in general, but I think it's also, that's the issue, that the three of us have to, he has to work with the three of us.
Mm-hmm.
And so he needs to make a commitment of the 6 months based on the fact that he's seeing the three of us,
mm-hmm.
not any one of us.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's why I don't, I mean, obviously I'm the contact person, but I feel that Trevor and Kip we're a board,
mm-hmm.
and he needs to work I mean, he's taken the risk on the three of us, not any one of us.
May I suggest over the long weekend you learn to play poker? And then watch MSN and watch the poker tournaments in Las Vegas?
Get a poker face going?
So looking forward, the board's going to want to do a 3 and a 5 month workup review with him. And you're going to want to set goals and parameters. If things are not working out in month 5, you're going to want to be able to say, point blank, without reason, this is just not working out. Just as you look forward, and that 3 to 5 months is going to pass by quick.
It is, and I think that is going to be a very tricky and difficult thing for us to set, because you know we don't want to set goals that are unobtainable, and we don't want. But yet, if you have none,
How do you judge?
You know, right. So,
why don't if you could you you guys think about it and forward it to Wendy. A couple of your priorities that you would want to make sure that we have some outline of what
I can also take a stab at something and get that out to you, what those might be. And welcome any kind of ideas you have to offer as well.
I think this is something important that we need to think about so that we can have that discussion with him without, you know, scaring him away or... you know, setting him up for failure.
Right. I don't want to do that.
No, it's actually to set him up to succeed.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This is what the board's really looking for to see from you. So he has a standard guideline to go,
he knows
all right,
what
Kip's over here and Trevor's here. This is what I need to do to make this job work.
Yeah.
I think it allows the candidate to really succeed.
I agree. I mean, and so could you work something up, Wendy? Because I think you have an understanding of what we need to do.
And then we'll circulate it. I would appreciate that.
Sure.
Yeah, and we can circulate it and have some document ready that this is the kind of stuff we were thinking of.
Okay, I'll just point out that last I knew you were planning to have a special town meeting on January 9th. Is that correct? No?
Are we still...
I don't know. I was still set for November 14th. But that
was that it?
Then it was what, December 5th?
Okay, well, the only reason why... forget the detail of that for a second. The reason why I brought it up was... There's one example of a attainable thing.
Yes.
I believe he can start immediately, and so gets
well, we
comes
have to take
board
care of Dick's
that gives him some
issues.
Time.
We do have some issues that we want to fix.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't. Now that we have the EMS donation, it's not as you know. Huge.
Okay. Well, we can. You know, between today and Friday, before I leave, I'm going to put a list of things together that are active, that are primary, that are, you know, need attention.
Thank you.
I would just ask you don't set too many goals to set them up for failure.
Right.
I would suggest one goal for each one of the select people would be sufficient, in my opinion. It just
goes by quick.
Does a special town meeting count for when, I mean, is...
Well,
out
I don't
there.
Want to see overwhelm the guy. The budget season.
Well, the warrant is almost done. I mean, it's pretty much done.
I actually think the kinds of things you want to see are what your best hopes are for him, which is how he communicates,
right?
And how the other town officials and town employees, how you do, you know, the exchange. That's a big piece of it, as well as certain. Tasks and projects, grasping those, being able to go elsewhere for assistance if needed, as opposed to plowing forward without the correct information, that kind of stuff.
Maybe you could make us a quick list of 3 or 4 things that you think are a priority for any town administrator to know in Massachusetts, whether it be budgeting or procurement or stuff like that. And then maybe we could have a conversation with him need to be honest, what's your ability here? And do you know where and how to, achieve more education on that? And, we could reach out to, I don't know if local universities or just MMA or where else he could learn this, but, a willingness on his half to get training in these areas.
Yeah.
And even though, you take a class in something for 3 or 4 days, you learn a lot. You don't know it all.
Right.
Right.
No, right.
That information is fed into you.
About the only thing classes for a town administrator is the procurement piece. Everything else is on the job, colleagues, working with the accountant or treasurer, that kind of stuff.
I guess I want to say that I think my priority would be that he become a certified procurement officer, because we don't have one, and we're required. So that would be, that would have to be on the list. He'd have to take those classes and pass the test. Because we're, I mean, we can't do RFPs, we can't do all kinds of stuff. I mean, we can work around it by having the FERCOG do it or something like that. But we need to do that. And then, and the state's going to come after us.
We can look at the training schedule, but you can also, we can have FERCOG do, and if you want to leave that in or out of the first 6 months in terms of an investment and whatever, you know, find out.
Well, I think it's a series of classes, so we have to look at the training schedule and see if you can at least take one class. If you can, if you can't pass the test, then that's an issue. I mean, that would be one thing.
What were you going to say?
My brain's scattered. I'm thinking of too many things at the same time.
Well, I'm pretty focused. I have to pick up my turkey, guys.
I was going to say, happy Thanksgiving to everybody.
Before you go, a couple
land.
Housekeeping items that came up with the DOR, what?
Oh, yes, yes. Sheet. Thank you for bringing that. We have to sign that letter.
We were told you have to, and if you would vote to do this.
Clean up my table.
This has to do with the sewer rates. DOR is requesting this. If you would vote that and sign that, it would be helpful.
And we have also that.
Would you read that and vote
okay,
on it?
Okay, so this is a memo to Henry Williams, Bureau of Accounts and Mass DOR, RA revolving account expenditure. The town of Deerfield will limit the expenditure from the receipts of for public health and safety revolving fund to an amount not to exceed $80,000.
Since there's no money in that account at the moment, I think there's probably not an issue of excessive spending.
Correct.
Wonder
so
what?
I make a
I
motion.
Second that.
Okay.
And all those in favor?
Aye.
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 Well, the question I have is that recently the town got some money, I believe it was for a gift and for a replacement of a vehicle, and Chief Pachurik informed me this morning, because of the new Mass Municipal Modernization Act, that the dollar amount is, if you purchase something that's under $25,001, you don't have to go out to the three conventional bids, just use good business practice. Is this something that I should be concerned with or know or find out, or I guess
that's you want to just verify that
verify.
Information?
Yeah.
I can try to verify that for you. Okay. I'm awash in all those changes as well,
yeah.
Because some of them were to the benefit and some were not to the communities.
We have that
you
list.
Have that 4,000,
and I think
yeah.
that is on the list, Kip.
Okay.
But if Wendy, if you could just verify it.
If he purchased it through the state, it doesn't.
No, I understand cover. That.
This
but
was independent.
Right,
then,
but
yeah.
I was going to go out shopping for one. To
Kip
help. I know what they
help.
Want and stuff like
that's
that.
That's what I want for Christmas.
Yeah. What is this, the sewer one? Did you?
Oh, no, that's the background
just
info.
The background
and
info.
Now Barb
okay.
is going to
yeah.
fax that over to Department of Revenue, and we can move forward with the tax
yes.
rate and getting the bill set.
So if we're all done, then I'll take a
motion to adjourn.
I'll second
happy
the
Thanksgiving to everybody.
Yeah, happy
yes,
Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to the entire community. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay.